There's something you really need to know about. And the man who's going to tell you about it, you've heard before, but you've got to listen today. And I'd like to introduce a good friend of ours who has done a mountain of work on a particular subject. Yeah. Billy Crone, you have worked very hard to put together two books, which I have reviewed, by the way, and some DVDs on a subject that a lot of people may not be too familiar with.
Yeah, but guess what, Gary? They need to be equipped on it because it is permeating every aspect of our lives, whether people realize it or not, and I'm convinced that it has everything to do with Bible prophecy. And of course, we're talking about artificial intelligence. And right out of the gates, I will say this, and I don't think it's too obtuse of a statement, but I believe that the birth of artificial intelligence and its dissemination across the planet, which is happening right now on a massive scale, is just a big of a watershed prophetic moment as when Israel became a nation in 1948.
Wow.
And the reason why I say that, let me explain, is because why was it so important that Israel became a nation? Because the seven-year tribulation, the Jewish people are one of the major key players. And so just logically, you can't have the seven-year tribulation until you have the Jewish people back on the scene. Well, guess what? They are. 1948, they became a nation. That was the big watershed moment. Gary, I'm convinced, based on this research, that the global events that are mentioned in the seven-year tribulation, I'm talking a global economy, a global mark of the beast system, a global big brother system, a global tying of the governments together, the knowing what people say and do, and globally micromanaging the planet, even to the point when an order is given to worship the Antichrist, they will know globally what these people are saying and doing. Did they respond? Did they obey? You can't have enough people on the planet to hire to run that back-end system. It's impossible, but guess what? Artificial intelligence allows that to happen on a global scale for the first time in mankind's history. It's here now, which means those events, not just Israel, those events can now take place. It's here now. That's why it's a huge watershed moment.
You know, I opened my Bible before we came on to 2 Timothy chapter 3, and we all know this. This is what I call the front side of Bible prophecy. This know also that in the last days perilous times shall come, for men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous boasters. The list goes on. And you've preached these words many, many times, yeah. I know. That's the front side.
Yeah.
There will be perilous times, and men will be lovers of their own selves. The back side of all this is sort of the invisible side of Bible prophecy. Some horrific things go on in the background that allow men to change the world in a revolutionary way. And this is scary stuff. Yeah. If you don't know the Lord, if your faith is not complete, and you read about the AI invasion, as Billy puts it, you could get pretty frightened.
But you mentioned that passage, Gary. That's the tool that they're using to dupe people to go along with literally having AI, I'm not joking, control the planet. To the point where one guy called the Antichrist is going to be able to push the button and he's going to control everything. Economy, education, agriculture, any kind of monetization, entertainment, military, religion, the whole nine yards, we cover it all. And it's here now, but how they're getting people to go along with that is that passage, lovers of self. It also says that society in the last days is going to love pleasure more than they love God. And that's how they're pitching AI. Let us let AI take over everything. It's gonna produce this wonderful, dare I say, hedonistic pleasure society. You're gonna be able to have so much more time on your hands. It'll manage your home, it'll manage your finances, it'll manage your transportation, it'll manage, even if you ain't got time for your kids or those elderly people, it'll even manage those people for you as well.
Yeah.
It'll manage the global economy, it'll manage the global stock market, it'll do everything for you as you just sit back and relax like George Jetson. That's how they're pitching it, and our society that loves self and loves pleasure more than God is falling for it. That's how they're getting this done.
And Billy's going back quite a way, the Jetsons. Mm-hmm. And it was a super wonderful future. Everything is perfect. You conquered all the health problems. You have conquered the monetary problems. You've conquered social problems, transportation problems. And that's the big sell that's going on right now.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, just go back to the transportation issue. I mean, that's how it's being pitched. Wouldn't it be great, Gary, if you could, you don't have to worry about driving your car. You could just sit back and relax. You could go back to texting because the car's driving itself. Or you could take a nap or, you know, whatever. You don't have to worry about it. It'll just get you there.
Right.
But there's, with all these aspects that we bring out, there's always, unfortunately, a negative side. And it has to do with literal micromanaging the planet, total global control, which the Bible says is going to happen in the 7-year tribulation. And just with the transportation, you go back to Matthew 24, when it says when the Antichrist goes up into the rebuilt Jewish temple, the abomination of desolation declares himself to be God. Paul talks about that in Thessalonians 2. And at that point, it says those who are in the 7-year tribulation, your only option is to flee, run, get out of there. Well, I'm convinced now with AI taking over the transportation, and it's not just cars, Gary. AI is now being responsible for all the transportation. They're pushing for cars, for trucks, semis. Most people don't realize, Gary, right now, there are semis across America that are shipping information. There are no human drivers. It's already here. It's not coming. It's already here. They're also doing the same thing to planes, to boats, subways, trains, you name it. Everything's being automated run. Now, put yourself in the Antichrist shoes. You don't want anybody to go anywhere. You don't want them to flee. You don't want, you know, you want to make sure that they stay and do exactly what you're going to hold that as leverage. You're going to keep them where you want them. Gary, that can happen right now, right? To the point when the order is given, when Jesus says, if you find yourself, unfortunately, not saved, you're in the 7-year tribulation, and you need to hightail it out of there, guess what? You ain't going nowhere. And the Bible says that at that point, it's going to be a bloodbath. The Antichrist is going to go on a slaughter fest, if you will, and he's going to murder people. And I think part of it is because people aren't going to be able to go anywhere. Even just something as simple as AI taking over the transportation industry has biblical global ramifications.
So we're talking about something that covers the entirety of society,
right?
Not just one or two categories, but everything, including military, financial, political, even educational.
Right, which means it's total global control of all these things for the first time in mankind's history. And when you read the book of Revelation and other Bible prophecy passages dealing with the 7-year tribulation, this is what you need. You need to be able to micromanage the planet. Gary, it's not coming, it's here. That's why we call this not just the AI, it's the AI invasion. It's already here, not coming, and it's invading every sector just in time for the 7-year tribulation. And again, here's the term that they're using to describe AI in the AI industry. This is their term, not mine. And they say AI is the new electricity. And they go, well, what's that? Well, here's why they call it that.
Wow.
And they're saying, like, well, just like when electricity was invented, it was a game changer for humanity.
Sure was.
And it was a buzzword. People talked about it. Oh, hey, this new thing called electricity. I wonder what it could do, and it's going to bring utopia and all this stuff. And then it began to die down a little bit, but electricity didn't go away. What did it do? It went behind the scenes and began to run everything in the background to the point where you and I take it for granted. We don't even think about it. Electricity runs everything. They're saying it's the same thing, not coming, already being done with AI. It's the new electricity. Yeah, people have heard the term as, oh, let's wonder what they're going to do with AI. It sounds kind of cool, kind of neat, kind of eclectic. They don't realize it's not going away even after the term dies down. It is now going across the planet, and AI is running the back end of everything. We deal with the businesses, the finances. It's going to run your home. It's going to run your whole city, your shopping, your service, your entertainment, the media, the gaming, the agriculture, communication, education, medical. That was a huge thing. It's going to take over all the medical industry. Big Brother, you can think. It's even taken over the police force where they're doing predictive policing, military, religion. Gary, this is why we said it's the AI invasion.
Wow.
It is literally the new electricity. It's permeating the planet. It's micromanaging everything just in time for a global dictator to do his dirty deeds in the 7-year tribulation.
And it all seemed so wonderful. I remember in the old Star Trek episodes, Doc had these little high-tech devices. And at I'll never forget one episode, somebody required an operation. And there was a an operational robotic procedure that was done, and bam, what would have killed us today, he was alive and well and walking, and you think, wow, that's great to have that kind of technology, but oops, you link something else to it, and that is, if this thing is smart enough to perform an operation, can it learn? Mm-hmm. And then can it join with others of its kind?
Right.
And after a while, do they begin to control things? That's the question you raise here. And I got to tell you, you need to know about this subject because Billy has gone very, very deeply into it, and it's going to affect your life.
Well, and again, Gary, I think certainly as Christians, we need to get equipped because, again, I'll say this. Based on the research, I'm absolutely convinced that as the church, we got to get equipped on this AI thing because it's just as big of a watershed moment as Israel becoming a nation in 1948. And what's unfortunate, and why we were excited to get this resource out, 3 years basically of research in the background, is that we can get equipped now. We need to understand this thing called AI and how it's taking over the planet just in time for the 7-year tribulation.
Now, let's talk about Skynet. What was sci-fi? You know, people have been predicting AI in sci-fi for at least 3 or 4 decades. And looking forward to this, and the good side of AI, artificial intelligence, is the helpful things that it can do.
Yeah.
The bad side is like Skynet, take over the world, control everything, as you put it, an antichrist system.
Yeah.
And where are we there?
Well, we got one whole section just on military, Gary.
Okay.
It's all in military. And it's not just our military, it's militaries around the world. And it's not coming, it's already being done. You mentioned Skynet, and I joke all the time. You want to know what's coming? Go watch the Terminator movies.
Yeah.
I'm not joking. It's like somebody is literally following a script, a Hollywood script. Now, we also know where it's headed because the Bible told us, you know, where it's headed ultimately, and it's not good. And you talk about Skynet. Skynet has already been built, Gary. Most people don't realize it. Only they don't call it Skynet. It's called Project Maven. And we expose this.
Say that again.
Project Maven.
Wow.
M-A-V-E-N.
Tell us about that.
Well, and guess who helped the military do that? It's basically Skynet because it's the AI running all the military for the United States. And that means not just the administration, the back end, the supply chain, all that stuff. It's making the decisions in the warfare, including when to pull the trigger on nuclear weaponry and things of that nature. It sounds crazy. It's already here. Google is the one who helped the U.S. military build this Project Maven, which is basically Skynet, and to run the military. Now, what's interesting is Google began to develop them, and you got to understand a little bit of background. We bring this out in Google. Google admitted, and we got this on tape back in the day, the reason why they came into existence, this is from Larry Page, one of the co-founders, him and Sergey Brin, they admitted the reason why they're here is not to build another search engine. We already had plenty of search engines when they came along. They said, we're here to create AI. These are the same guys who, it's still in print, said we want to, quote, be like the mind of God. They want to know everything about everybody. Now, so these guys are now taking their AI and they're helping the military build this Skynet called Project Maven. Well, the employees got in a little bit of a ruckus, as the story goes, and said, we don't like using our talents and our AI to teach the military how to let AI basically make commands to kill people. So they backed out. Well, that's where Microsoft came in and helped them finish the job. But then you're thinking, well, hey, Google, that's great because remember they had this mantra that don't be evil? So surely they did that for a great, wonderful, no. Google, it sounds crazy, Gary. Google now has patented, they want to create their own robot army. I'm not joking. It sounds like it's a science fiction movie or conspiracy, it's not. So you got all that going on, but back to the
wait a minute, I've got to stop you there. Whoa, what's this robot army going to do?
Well, thank you, exactly. And why does Google need a robot army? Well, and I'm sitting there going like, well, you already said you want to be like the mind of God. Maybe if your AI God that you want to control the planet with, if people get out of the line, then you got your AI robot army around to take. It's crazy, but this is literally what these people are doing behind the scenes.
Now, this one, I've got to stop you right there and say, what he's saying is documented. I mean, read it. I mean, you may sit there and shake your head right now and say, that can't be happening. It's happening.
It's happening, and it's happening on a global scale, and it's not just our country. It's militaries around the world. It's corporations around the world. It's not just Google. There's Microsoft. Facebook is another huge one. Amazon's another huge one, especially when it comes to the buying and selling aspect, which goes right into the Mark of the Beast system, and we document all that stuff. But back to the military. So they didn't just create Maven. You think, okay, so they have an AI to control the whole military. How are they going to do that? At the same time, they're taking the military equipment and they are allowing it to be run by AI. So that an AI general, if you will, a Project Maven, a Skynet, can literally control the battlefield. Gary, pick any kind of military vehicle you can think of. And I'm not joking. It's not coming. It's already here. And you don't need humans to fight wars anymore. And it's not just America. It's militaries around the world. Pick a military piece of equipment, and they are unmanning them, and AI is controlling them. No people involved. So guess what? Now you got Project Maven that will be making the decision to send out all this military equipment. Then they're also at the same time developing what's called micro-aerial vehicles. And these are miniaturized vehicles. It could look like a fly. They mimic typically insects, like flies or dragonflies or, you know, things of that nature. And they're not coming, they're already here. And they demonstrate, and we share the actual military videos from the Navy, from the Army, and from the Air Force. And where they're actually equipped, where they can fly in into, you know, an area, and they carry a payload, and they could take somebody out in the back of the head. It, this is not coming, it's already here. Then they're also developing, I kid you not, militarized animals, where now they're making robotic animals like robotic cheetahs, robotic sharks, and we demonstrate all this, robotic jellyfish. There's no way to escape. And they're also arming them as well. Then, on top of that, they're making actual Terminator robots. It's not coming, it's already here, we document it. And I'm not joking, Gary, DARPA, if you're familiar with DARPA, the Defense Advanced Research Project Agency, for years has been developing what's called neuromorphic chips. Now, that's just basically, in a nutshell, a fancy way of saying a brain chip. And these brain chips that mimic the human cortex, they're popping into these robots, and they're basically said the robot can learn and act on its own. And we demonstrate the videos how far this technology is already come. These things can do backflips. They could even dance. They could, I got to share this. Sorry, one more. Russia just came out with a video, which we share. Their Terminator robot is called Fedor, F-E-D-O-R. People go check it out. I'm not making this up. And Fedor can not only do push-ups, it can use power tools, and it shows it all on tape. It could drive a Jeep, and it actually shoots guns in both hands simultaneously, and it does not miss its target. Now, put all that together. You got these unmanned vehicles, every piece of military equipment think of. You got these micro vehicles. You got militarized animal-looking robots. You got Terminator robots. And then, guess what? You've already created Project Maven to control the whole thing, exactly like Terminator, Gary, and it's already here.
And I was thinking, as Billy was talking, those little flying robots, those could be loaded with poison. And they go buzz, and they sting you on the cheek, and you're dead before you can swat them.
Right, sting you, or they come also, and this is the example from the Air Force. And we show it. This, I'm not making this up. And they go into the, they sneak into, like, it's like a suburban area, like you're going into Afghanistan or one of those areas, and the guys are hiding out, whatever. It sneaks into the door behind the guy, and he's behind a gun looking out the window, right? And this MAV fly comes in, and it has a combustible payload. Pops in the back of the head, the guy's dead. It's the actual video.
I just had to open to Revelation 9, and verse 7. And the shapes of the locusts were like unto horses prepared unto battle, and on their heads were crowns like gold, and their faces were like the faces of men. Yeah. Could these be robots of some kind swarming across a battlefield?
Well,
we think of them as demons, a demonic horde, but couldn't a demonic horde operate in cooperation with AI vehicles?
Well, it's funny you mentioned swarm. Now, as creepy as the scenario I just described to you that's already here, Project Maven, basically Skynet, controlling every piece of military equipment that you can think of, jet fighters, submarines, tanks, you name it, on land, on water, underwater, micro-air vehicles mimicking insects, flies, birds, sharks, the militaries, and Terminator robots. They've also developed what's called swarm technology. We share from the Army, it's called the MAST program, Micro-Autonomous Systems Technology. We also, with the Navy, and the swarm technology, basically what it does is it allows all these individual AI-controlled military pieces of equipment to control, to communicate with each other, and then swarm the prey. One of the examples that we share from the Navy is they're putting it on their boats, and so they say that when they're patrolling the waters, it isn't just one AI unmanned boat that's chasing down a potential terrorist or threat to the bigger ships. No, it sends out signals to the rest of the AI boats, and they come together as a pack, as a swarm. And this is their term, like locusts. Wow. And they come and they surround the prey and basically tell them to stop, cease, go away, or we're gonna take you out. No humans involved. This is the technology. The Army one that we show is these MAVs. They show an MAV spider, an MAV moth, and an MAV dragonfly. And they're working together. In fact, they're communicating with each other with the swarm technology. And in order for them to complete the mission, well, how are you gonna get the spider where it needs to go underneath the door to with its camera eyes to see what's going on in that room, to report it back to headquarters? Well, it shows the dragonfly coming by, scooping up the
spider
and dropping it off on the stairs that just starts going up and goes. It's crazy. You're thinking like, come on, this can't be real. And then you're going like, oh, it's gotta be a long ways away. Gary, it's already being used. And yeah. It's not our country, it's countries around the world.
I want to interrupt you at this point. I hate to interrupt, Billy, because I have gone through these two volumes. The Final Countdown, Tribulation Rising, the AI Invasion. Two very, very well-documented volumes. And, by the way, a DVD set. And we're going to pause at this point and let you know how you can obtain these for yourself.
As you've heard here today, AI is in the process of taking over every aspect of society. Self-driving cars, robotic surgery, lightning-fast communication. It all sounds so good. But the Bible tells us how these seemingly helpful benefits to society will be used to usher in the dark agenda of the Antichrist in the future. Google, Facebook, Microsoft, unmanned drones, military robots, exploding dragonflies. Where exactly is all of this high technology taking us? And where does the mark of the beast fit into this agenda? Billy Crone has taken the study of artificial intelligence to a whole new level with his two new books and a companion DVD set that explains it all. AI Invasion reveals things that will catch most people by surprise, even Christians who study the prophecies of the Bible. Billy accumulated so much advanced information that he needs two books to share all the details. And his DVD set includes 12 DVDs and 24 separate studies. It is the most comprehensive study on artificial intelligence and the Antichrist system ever compiled. The lengthy two-book study is available in what we're calling the AI Book Package for your gift of $50 or more to Prophecy Watchers. We're also making the 12 DVD set available in the AI DVD Package for your gift of $50 or more to the ministry. We've included a special bonus with either package, a 400-page book by well-known prophecy author Ron Rhodes, The Chronological Tour of the Bible, a book that will take you step by step through God's plan for the future. If the end times are still a bit confusing to you, this book will help you see the big picture. For your gift of $100 or more, we'll send you the Artificial Intelligence Package with both of Billy's books, his 12 DVD set, The Chronological Tour of the Bible book by Ron Rhodes, plus Gary Stearman's brand new DVD, The Last Trump, a study of the rapture trumpet of 1 Corinthians 15. Just call the toll-free number on your screen or visit our online bookstore at prophecywatchers.tv to stand with us today. The new electricity has arrived, but it's hardly the long-awaited utopia the world imagines. There's a sinister plan at work here. Some call it the New World Order. Others call it the Great Reset. The Bible calls it the Tribulation. Part of our mission statement at Prophecy Watchers is to be an encouragement to you and to keep as many people as possible out of the tribulation. Will you help us support that critical mission with a gift to our ministry? Thanks for watching, and as always, we hope today's program was a blessing and an encouragement to you. Even so, come Lord Jesus.
I think you're going to want to avail yourself of all this information because it's happening. It's happening now. And Billy, our problem sitting here right now is there's just too much to say.
Yeah. Yeah.
You really can't put all of the drama of this thing,
yeah,
the nearness of it,
yeah,
into words.
Well, and it's a massive information. And I hope that, you know, people don't misunderstand my saying this. I'm just excited to get this resource out. It's about a 3-year project. I'm not boasting when I say this, but Garrett, I don't think you're going to find anything on the planet as well documented, as exhaustive on this study, and certainly,
yes,
dare I say, how it has to deal with Bible prophecy.
And I can vouch for that. You talk about documentation. Page after page after page. If you want to pursue this subject yourself, the volumes will give you a pathway to follow. It's an amazing thing, but what's to me, what is on my heart at this very moment is how close we are,
yeah,
to the end days of Bible prophecy.
Right.
The dramatic days of Bible,
right,
prophecy.
Well, and go back to what we just talked about, just on the one of the different topics we deal with, the military. I'm convinced that this is the technology that the Antichrist is going to use, right? And it answers some questions. Because again, you got global events, you got global wars. In the sealed judgments, and it says there 1/4 of the earth is going to be annihilated. In the trumpet judgments following that, you got 1/3 of the earth being annihilated. And so to me, I'm going like, well, how do you take out so many people so fast, in a short amount of time, and dare I say, without using full-on nuclear warfare? Because if it was nuclear that you're doing to kill 1/4 of the planet, then another 1/3, we'd be in a global winter. So how are you going to take out, in a rapid amount of time, 1/4 of the planet, and then later 1/3. Gary, what I'm describing to you literally gives, for the first time in mankind's history, one man to push a button, and through AI, you could run the militaries around the planet, and they will hunt you down, anybody he wants, on a micromanaged scale, and you could take out a massive amount of people, dare I say, what the text implies there in Revelation, and you never once dropped a nuke. That technology is here now.
Wow, I'm breathless. Billy Crone has gone the extra mile to put together something that you need to know about. The final countdown, tribulation rising, we all agree on that. The AI invasion, artificial intelligence, we need to talk some more. I mean, we need another program, and we need to talk about the intelligence part.
Oh yeah.
I'm Gary Stearman. Hey, you keep watching. We are. Thanks for joining us on Prophecy Watchers. You can find us on the web at prophecywatchers.com, where you can sign up for our free email newsletter. In the meantime, keep watching, everybody, and we'll see you soon.